Hey class, so this is assignment number 47. The date would be March 11th, and it is on the geography and early China. It talks about what China is going to look like geographically, right? So the physical and cultural features of the land, as well as some of the early dynasties in China. So here are the main ideas. Remember on your notes, these will be the blue titles or the titles on the left that you'll have visuals for. The first main idea is that China's physical geography made farming possible, but travel and communication difficult. And we'll see why that's the case shortly. The second main idea, civilization began in China along the Huanghe and Changjiang rivers. Huanghe, another name for that river, is the Yellow River. We often hear that more over here. And three, China's first dynasties helped Chinese society develop and made many other achievements. All right, so this PowerPoint, I'll just have images and I'll be talking. And so you just need to listen. And I might add some questions with Edpuzzle, but we'll see. All right, so this first picture here, what this is showing is the size of China. So China is nearly 4 million square miles. And you can see when China here is compared to the United States, their sizes are very, very similar. You can see how the outline of China overlaps to the States. They're very close in size. So China is a massive country. A massive country with harsh deserts in the north over here. It has the Pacific Ocean over here to the east, and mountain ranges to the west. So what that resulted is in this central area, that's where a lot of the farmland was, and it isolated China. Okay. It is so big, China is so big, kind of like the United States, that different areas will have different weather at the same time, right? So over here, you might have super, super hot weather, whereas down here, it might be snowing. So dramatically different weather in different parts of the country. The Huanghe, or the Yellow River, this is a picture of the Yellow River here. It stretches 3,000 miles. It's not the longest river. I believe the Changjiang is longer. And that one goes all the way to the Pacific Ocean. But the Huanghe, when it floods, rich silt, right? We've heard that word before, silt, is left behind for farming. And that's a good thing, right? It makes the soil better for crops and the stuff grows better there. But at the same time, flooding can be very dangerous and destructive, which we see a picture here. This is not ancient civilization, ancient China. No, this is, I don't know the exact year, but maybe within the last 100 years. And you can see how devastating the flood was. It's people, you know, the water's up to people's chests. So that's quite destructive and dramatic. Okay, so in 7,000 BC, which is what, about, you know, what would that be? About 9,000 years ago, Chinese farmers were growing a couple of main crops. They were growing rice in along the Changjiang, which is the other river, not the Yellow River, the other river. And they were growing millet and wheat along the Huanghe, which would look something more like this. I feel like traditionally when you're looking at pictures of rice paddies, rice fields, you'll see they're flooded over. That's not always the case, but they'll often look like this, whereas wheat will more often look like this. They also fished, hunted, and domesticated pigs and sheep, right? Domesticated, remember that means made them, they would raise them for their own purposes, their own uses, right, for food and the like. In their villages, their homes were partly underground, made with straw roofs. So this picture doesn't exactly show that, but this is probably a little bit after. But the homes that they had in the early Chinese period would be, they had straw roofs and were partly underground. This picture does show that there was a wall that surrounded the village for protection. And then another important detail of early Chinese society was they filled their tombs with objects for the afterlife, kind of like the Egyptians, actually very much like the Egyptians, so that they would have the items they needed in the afterlife. And in particular, wealthy people were often buried with objects made from jade, which look like this. Jade is a hard gemstone that has kind of a greenish, turquoiseous color, like this. So the first dynasties. The first kind of big figure, and this is largely according to legend. Like here you can see this cool-looking comic book cover for Yu the Great, who was a legend. And the legend goes with Yu the Great, there were these massive floods in China, which is not surprising considering, right, the what we just I mentioned before, of the Huanghe and the Changjiang flooding over. And what he did was he thought about it, and he had his people dig channels to the ocean. So the water from the floods was then carried to the Pacific and prevented the floods from destroying China, so thus saving it. So that's kind of the big thing that goes with Yu the Great and his legend. He was one of the first Xia rulers, Xia, X-I-A, the Xia dynasty. But the first dynasty that we know definitely existed was the Shang dynasty, and they built their civilization along the Huanghe. The king ruled with help from nobles and advisors who give him tips for how to run his dynasty. Nobles owned land. Warriors also did well and, you know, protected the countryside. And artisans were in the middle, people that made stuff. And at the bottom, to be expected, you've got farmers and slaves. Here is a picture of a Shang warrior with a bow, and that's one of the advances they had, were more advanced bows. Okay, so Shang developed China's first writing system that had symbols that represented words and sounds and stuff. And there were more than 2,000 symbols in this writing system, and writing was found on bones and turtle shells, which suggested oracles, which are predictions being made. So they would write stuff on say, a bone or a shell. They would heat it up, and then depending on how the bone or the shell cracked, that would tell them what was going to happen in the future. So these are called oracles or predictions. And the last thing I'm going to mention here is the Shang developed other advances, such as chariots. You can see a chariot here. Powerful bows, which they're carrying here, and bronze armor. You can see they're wearing armor here. I don't know if that's bronze, but they definitely developed bronze body armor during this time, as well as an advanced calendar system, which this is a picture that I found of an early Shang calendar. So the big idea you need to take from this, in addition to the main ones, are that Chinese civilization began with the Shang dynasty along the Huanghe, which again, Huanghe is the Yellow River. So, thanks, and yeah.